After launching Launcher, click on Launch version 4.26.1, then select Games, Blank, Next and Ray Tracing. I select No Starter Content, name my file by the name of the project, and set the location where the Unreal project files will be saved. And click Create Project. It will take some time for our engine to start, and after that compilation will take place in the lower right corner. This can be seen from the materials. It will take some time. After that, right click to create a level, sign it so that you understand what level it is. Go to a new level by double clicking on it. And don't save the old one. Don't save. Next settings, project settings, maps and modes. Set the level that we just created. Type ray tracing in the search. Check that we have ray tracing. Also check that DirectX 12 is enabled for us. Then go to the rendering section, and here we need to put these two checkboxes. Then set the screen space reflection to 1024. And turn off bloom and auto exposure. That's all. These are settings that we needed to enable. We go to Settings, Plugins, look for GPU Light Mask, turn on GPU Light Mask, put a checkmark, further in the search, Datasmith, and look for built-in and all here. You can select, sometimes no category is selected and cannot be found. We need a Datasmith importer, put a checkmark, and after we have enabled the necessary plugins, press Restart. While Unreal is restarting, switch back to 3ds Max. We need to export the file. Export selected. Next, we select the folder where we want to export our file with Datasmith. Create a folder. Sign it so that we later understand what is in this folder, and having written the name of the saved file. Also select Unreal Datasmith. And OK. We are waiting for some time while our files are saved and prepared. It takes some time, because the file will be quite heavy in volume. We ignore all these errors and move on to Unreal. We close the window that opens. In Content, simply expanding content, select it, click on Datasmith, select the file that we saved with you, and look, it already weighs 700 megabytes for such small volumes. For such small geometry. In the window that appears, the last three checkboxes, light cameras and animation, are removed. The maximum light mask size of 1024 is specified and import. Importing will take some time, and that's it. Our geometry is imported. It is not visible because there is no light. Here at the top in the left corner, turn on Unlit so that you can see only the diffuse component of the materials. Next, our task is to create light. I will use one white pixel saved in HDRI. This is just one pixel, it weighs 1 kilobyte. As you can see, we just move our folder and drag and drop. One pixel is converted into a full-fledged HDRI, which weighs very little. We drag in the skylight on the left in the search. Drag the skylight, put the controller, put the specified cube map, and drag our HDRI to the active cell. Be sure to make sure it's static. Put skylight static and don't forget to save. Save more often. Save all will save all assets. And at the top, save current will save your level. Go from unlit to lit, then build. Select the first line. Click here. Select bake what you see. The noise will be removed during the interactive preview. And click build lighting. The light began to bake. At the bottom, in the lower right corner, we see that the files are being compiled. These are progress bars being loaded. And in order for the power of the skylight to manifest itself, we need to change the intensity scale. Now it is not very clear what our light looks like. In order to deal only with the setting the light, We will do the following. First, set a larger value, for example, about 100. And set it to display only the light, lighting only. And we will increase the values of the strength of our HDRI. 200, 500, you can set 1000 or 2000. The exposure can then be edited in the post process. Make it brighter, as long as the strength is sufficient. You can, for example, bet 1000, but with a strong difference between 500 and 1000, you will not see here. In this case, we look at our scene. See that the light is shut off. Below you see slow mode, so that the light starts to bake faster. We need to turn off real time at the top left in the active window. Slow mode disappears and our calculation is faster. I will click cancel here, select full bake in the settings and start baking the light again. That is, now the light will not be baked interactively, but the whole scene. That is, before that I showed how to enable interactive rendering. You will see that calculation those areas to which your gaze is directed. We turn on full bake, we will already have baking of the entire scene. After baking, turn on real time by turning off real time off. Where we have insufficient quality shadows or some artifacts, we select this object. In detail, we write light in the search, check the overridden checkbox, increase the light map's values, then world settings. We need to open the light mask settings and immediately set the maximum value here to 4096. We will substitute 12 for the number of bounces. Here are indirect lighting bounces. We will continue to look for objects that needed to increase the light mask value and increase it. If you see that the object is very large, for example, we put it on the ceiling, you see here, and artifacts are formed. Here is a large surface, 4096. We put it, this is the maximum value, because the floor and ceiling collects a lot of shadows, as well as, in principle, walls. Here you can safely indicate 2048, and here we will temporarily put 2K on the curtains. Select the entire tool. Click with Ctrl pressed. Tool and curtains are the most problematic. The geometry and generation of automatic UVs is always bad, and therefore you have to overestimate these values, in this case 2048. Then probably I'll put 4000, we'll see. It seems to be a simple object, but you see how auto UV is not doing very well. So we have to raise. It was easy to leave 256 there, but I leave the value of the small objects to 1024. But for example, the base is even simpler. You could specify 128. I indicated 512. The floor, as I said, is the same as the ceiling. 496 we indicate. We will not see the bake wall, so we can ignore it. Further, with the sofa armrest, for example, here you can specify 1000. And you can also make a backrest 1024. All other objects of the sofa look normal. This seat can be increased. Done. But the carpet will collect a lot of shadows, so we also raise the value 2K for it. Do not forget to save Ctrl plus S and save all. Let's see how much baking was before we increased the light mass. To do this, Windows, Developer Tools, Output Log, and write in total in the search. Let's see that for 4 minutes the light was rendered with a lower UV's value. It was 256, and because of the automatic scanning, we had to increase this value by 2, or even 4 times. We start baking. We check right away that it starts well now. It bakes well here. Turn off real time and wait for the light to bake. For a quick project, when you just need to make a video and you have a powerful video card, then automatic UVs are allowed. But if you need interactive, for example, then you definitely need to do UVs manually, with high quality and controlling each island of UVs. overestimated scan resolutions not only lengthen the rendering of light, but also make the project harder. In the World Settings tab, uncheck the compressed light maps. It is important that light maps then, when they are baked, so that they do not shrink, save more often. Do not forget that despite of Unreal is a stable program, it also crashes. Now we'll compare how long the light will be baked over time with the increased light maps. First, let's check what the quality of baking the light turned out to be. As you can see, the light bakes well. The most important thing that affects the quality of the light is the UVs. I would like a better UVs on the tool and on the curtains. Perhaps the texture on the material will cover small artifacts, but large artifacts on the panels cannot be hidden. Let's see how much light was baked this time. Total time in output log is 35 minutes. The light has been baked for more than 8 times. And we still have artifacts on the large panels. After selecting the tool, press Ctrl plus E, the model editor, go to, look at the UVs that was created. In its settings, in the detail light we type, in the overridden light map res we specify 4096. We do the same with the tool, we change the details behind the objects of the split tool. But let's first select the panel and specify 4096. Here we also see a fairly large number of artifacts that most likely the texture of the material will not hide. Not everything is so good with the ceiling either. But this is the part that we will not see and see how rebaking on the ceiling will affect. On these panels, where there were a lot of artifacts, the light map's value was doubled. Check all objects for artifacts and incorrect UVs. More around the scene and try to find some bugs, artifacts and inverted UVs. The leg looks strange. Select it and press Ctrl plus E. And if the normal of the objects are inverted, then go to Mesh Editing, Edit Mode, select the element, and then I show how to flip this element. That is, the normals will unfold. We save the project. I'll start baking the light and leave the baking process behind the scenes. The light is baked. With the curtain it has become a little better. With the panels there are still artifacts, but the texture of the material will cover these minor artifacts. We can see that ...2048 could be raised to 4096. But that's enough for now. We have small artifacts. We have small artifacts, these artifacts stand out strongly on the tool. If you look closely, the surfaces flicker when you move. This is normal. You can then remove this by turning off the progress bars. When we have these green things appear, which show how much each texture is baked in time. In the output log, we look at the total time and this time we see from 35 minutes, including the light maps UVs, we have up to 1 hour 34 minutes increased the calculation time.